the Negro, scattered around the world by way of the transatlantic slave trade. And in the U.S., they're known as African Americans. However, have you ever taken the time to look up the word Negro in the Webster Dictionary? Well, let's take a closer look. The Webster Dictionary defines the word Negro as, and I quote, a member of a race of humankind native to Africa and classified according to physical features such as dark skin pigmentation. This is what we would expect to find for the definition of the word Negro. However, very few people scroll down to read the section located near the bottom of the page, which reads, first known use of Negro, 1555, in the meaning defined above. In other words, the first written record of the word Negro, meaning an African, started in the year 1555. In other words, the word Negro did not refer to a person of African descent until the year 1555. And with that in mind, the question would be, then who were the people called Negroes before 1555? You see, the transatlantic slave trade started in the year 1501. And the slaves on the first transatlantic slave ships were called Negroes. In fact, King Ferdinand and Queen Isabel of Spain made it mandatory that only Negroes who were born in Spain and Portugal would be allowed to go to the Americas as slaves. In other words, these Negroes were Spanish and Portuguese natives. And so we need to know who was called Negroes in Spain and Portugal before 1555. Now, in 1492, we see the Spanish Jews who fled into Portugal after being expelled from Spain. We see these Jews were called Negroes, as the following reference reads. And it reads, King John II in 1492 expelled all the Jews to the island of St. Thomas, which had been discovered in 1471, and to other Portuguese settlements on the continent of Africa. And from these banished Jews, the black Portuguese, or the Negro Portuguese, as they are called, and the Jews in Luango. Not only were these Spanish and Portuguese Jews called Negroes, they also took on the last name of Negro. For example, we see Jews in Portugal with the names Yahya Negro, or Judah Negro, and Dawid or David Negro. In addition to being called Negro and having last names of Negro, these Jews were described as black, dark complexion, brown, and swarthy in color. Some references compare the color of these Jews to the Bicaris of Africa, who look like the so-called Negroes today. We also see the skulls of the Spanish Jews identified as dolichocephalic, which is the skull of the so-called Negro today. And finally, we see the word Negro associated with these Spanish and Portuguese Jews over and over again. For example, when these black Jews got sick, they called it the Black Plague. When these black Jews were persecuted by the Inquisition Book of Laws was called the Black Book. And when the Spaniards denied the persecution of these black people, they referred to the persecution as a Black Legend. In other words, we see black, 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 and black when referring to these Jews. In fact, these Jews were called black for hundreds of years, and it wasn't referred to as being anti-Semitic. You see, anti-Semitic is a term that didn't come into existence until the late 1800s. So the question would be, how can someone be anti-Semitic by calling a Jew black? When the Brews had last names of Negro. Think about it. If you want to learn more about these black Jews, then tune into the Dr. Mary Lee Show this Wednesday at 9 p.m. Eastern with co-hosts James Cannon, Michael Tynes, and your brother Benaiah Israel. For more shocking truths, well, hope to see you there, family. Stay blessed and shalom.